chicharrón.
Qué lindas son, qué lindas son. Qué lindas son las canciones.
Beautiful.
De mi tierra,
Puerto Rico, Boricua, the Hibarín, Mr. Mojón. You know me as motherfucking Don Chicharrón, King Kong in the Bronx. Brooklyn nigga gonna give you what you want. Fuego en los ojos, monstruo de los monstruos. With a chokehold on the old gold. Cerveza fresca que nepas en trenzas. This the best spot to get shot.
Come on!
I'm in the hood, 80K house, $1 million neck. Shout out 200 rounds, niggas know the rap. Coke be the best, we talk no steps. Headshot, took off, sold less. More jelly kicks, more jelly sweats. I'm on the yard doing burpees, me drop the fresh. We shoot a landlord, he got a new body. Pray to Tesla X, need a new body. 50K got my bitch a new body. You internet, niggas, y'all pool 90. The Ace of Spades sipper, yay dealer. Pray 5 times a day, get on the wave, nigga. Baddest bitch you ever seen doing my braids, nigga. Tech echo like it got delays, nigga. This shit ain't shit, get out your way, nigga. New Yeezys only me and Ye with him. Pay attention. 400, baby, come back at least 7. Canteen to the rec yard, I got the weapon.
Butcher coming, nigga.
Yo.
You know how I rock 6 figures off Zaza. Come and spin at my shop, I turn your hood to a hot spot. Every game I feel like I'm Dame, without a stopwatch. Shooting before the shot clock, Griselda got the top spot. Locked down like a pawn shop, nigga, I'm thinking why not. I gave my life to the game, but what do I got? Father these niggas how, I don't even know my pops. This flip phone that I got don't connect to the Wi-Fi. This new foreign shit with the wood on the door. Got me beefing with some niggas I coulda put on. They make up lies and put them in songs. I pull up the lies, cop and down the block, hit me pulling the yard. Yeah, praying with my dirty hands. I did dirt and scam. I'm asking God, do I deserve these bands? And we from Murderland, Eastside shit, jeans purple brand. Ryan in the GLE, the turtle van.
You throwing shots, you better be precise. If I only squeeze it twice, that's me being polite. We was in the trenches, nigga. 4 chicken wings and rice. The shooter 14 can't read or write, but he gon' squeeze his pipe. We was trying to sell a key a night, cause Nas said a G a night wasn't good enough, and he was right. They mad I'm rich, same niggas that wouldn't see my plight. The next plan, I'm riding to the game with KD tonight. Yeah. Machine bitch, A beat our body. My nigga on his way home, he just beat a body. Every time I leave the house, I got the steamer body. My jacket a one of none, you never seen it probably. I took some cheddar out the vault to pay the lawyer for my man. Weapon possession and felony assault. Whipping up at Unk House, he keep the resi off the fork. I'm Kyrie, hitting niggas with the hezzy on the court. Look, I reached a point niggas never would've thought. Cause every time I drop something, I don't never get support. FN Max shot severing your corpse. You never could extort me. My heart cold is February 4th. They hate to see me win, I'm not surprised. Nigga, I'm fucking the bitches, them bum bitches you fuck idolize. I'm in Harlem at Lighthouse eating lobster fries. V and Shooter with me, I got mobster ties. Machine.
I grew up with the dark side, apartheid. But going against the grain and get you kidnapped and hogtied. Ex illest nigga, fittest nigga. Never been scared, I'm a fittest nigga. Look at the cannon, that'll remove your head and shoulders. Catch that plan is banned, get ran over. I'ma make you hand over anything you got. Damn it, I'm out the average motherfucker. Damn it, cause I'm a savage. Sometimes I can't manage all the shit in my head. I was promised a growl, but I got the dirt instead. Killing like I was bred, shed, blood. It's always trippy, fuck you, nigga, what? Built for war, rolled us all forward. We'll hit you to the door, to accept snow for me. I done poked more niggas in ass and touch it. Westside, Conway, X, Freddy, butcher, nigga. Get like you live, nigga. Get how you fucking live, nigga. You know what the fuck it is? You know what the fuck it is? I ain't 50 years old for nothing. We act not 50 years old for nothing. Fuck. Small time call, wish a nigga would. And I wish a nigga would.
yo, yo, what's up, everybody? This is your boy, Curtis Blow. And whenever I'm not in prayer or touring the world, I'm tuned in to Check the Rhyme Radio with my favorite Puerto Rican, GQ, the Embassy. Cheer!
Cheer, cheer, cheer. Salute, salute, salute. Orlando and worldwide. Make sure you're tuned in to Check the Rhyme with your favorite Puerto Rican, GQ the Embassy, every Sunday from 6 to 7 p.m. right here on Indie Jams Radio. Cheer. Salute.
What's up, this is Stagger Lee. When I'm not at Family Dollar shopping for the smallest possible size Ziploc bags, I'm listening to Check the Rhyme on Indie Jams Radio.
Check the Rhyme.
Cheer, 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 salute, 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 Orlando and worldwide. You are now tuned in to another episode of Check the Rhyme right here on Indie Jams Radio. I am your favorite Puerto Rican, GQ the Ember, alongside my shooter, Josh Diggity Dollars, up in the hit it 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 it
I was gonna see how long you
can go. I'm about to do that. I'm gonna have to try that. Just one long ass breath and shit. You know what I'm saying?
What up, man?
What's popping with you,
what's
my brother?
What's the word, baby? I'm blessed, man. We here.
Yo, man, we here. You know what I'm saying? Could have been anywhere else in the world. Shout out to Barra. You know what I'm saying?
What's good, Barra?
What's going on, man? Yeah, to get you mic'd up now. You know what I'm saying? It's all love. But let's continue. We got a special guest up in the house today. This man is a battle vet. You know what I'm saying? He's
definitely
an MC. He's a league. Oh, no, you don't get. Your mic is off right now. Hold on 1 second. He's a league owner. He's a husband. He's a father. This man's a hard worker. He's an entrepreneur. You know what I'm saying? Who
talk
else?
That, talk
he's
that shit.
Probably man. The best peanut butter and jelly makerer. You know what I'm saying? Who the. That's a fact, goddammit.
All time
you know
favorite snack, right?
For
there,
those man. that who don't know, whoever's been living under a boulder, under the rock, under the crevice with a couple of worms and a couple of shrubs and grubs and all that good shit. We are talking about the man, the myth, the legend, and
the
this
one
man,
and only.
This man has brought to me one of the best interviews in our career here in podcasting with Cortez. This guy is a beast. I can't say anything else. I probably could, but I'd only be hearing myself speak. Casino 183rd
Casino
is in the building. One time for you, my brother.
One time for Casino in the building.
Yeah, man.
What's the word, Casino? How you doing, brother?
I'm good. 1-2, 1-2. Can you hear me?
Oh, yeah. I can hear you, man.
Right, cool. Nah, man. Salute for having me at the show again, man.
Come on, man. You know you are a friend to the show, your family man. Member here, whatever the good stuff that we can say, that is you. You know what I'm saying? Friend of the show. We got Barra also in the building, you know what I'm saying? Who sneaks in, of course, from time to time. It's all love. He's actually a part of this shit. Let me just get you mic'd up to my friend.
Give yourself a check.
Let's
check,
see.
Check.
There you go.
There he is. It's all good. Listen, we love you too, brother. It's all love.
It's not about me, though.
It's always about us. Trust me. Even you, Barra, you know what I'm saying? You're doing major things for the city. So we appreciate you. But also, we are here to represent Casino 183rd and, of course, Brevard Battle Arena. First of all, thank you for bringing it back.
BBA.
Thank y'all for, supporting before I brought it back. You know what I'm saying?
Facts. We done had a few conversations.
Man, chewing my ear off about it. You know what I mean?
Yeah. That was me? That was bad. My fault.
That's
my
real, fault. Though. That's real.
Shit.
I needed that.
Yeah.
You know, I needed that.
You know, a little push.
No,
you
we
know?
Had a little conversation about it, too, though.
Yeah.
Well, he not the only one.
Yeah.
I'm sure
a couple
saying?
People was just like...
A couple battle rappers mentioned my name in their battles.
Oh, yeah, that is
true. In
their
bars recently, so...
Good things, bad things, mixture?
It made me feel like the...
That was good.
Okay. The game calling me back in different ways. You know what I'm saying?
100%.
Good to have you back, bro.
100%, man. It's what the culture
the
needs.
More the merrier, man.
Yeah, it's what the culture needs. You know what I'm saying?
Word.
I mean, you have leagues that are doing their thing, but I feel like when you have a bunch of good leagues, it complements each other.
Right.
And it continues to really push the culture forward, not just your own personal battle league agenda.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? What's your take on that, bro, as a league owner?
I agree. Completely.
Dope.
Yeah, I
think it just has to do with these guys out here having an outlet, you know?
Facts.
And it offers more opportunity for newer guys, too.
Right.
To expand.
So much more opportunities
for
different MCs out there, you know, to be able to reach out to people like Casino, to Berra, you know, like,
yeah,
it just brings everybody together, man. Everybody eats, you know?
And the beauty of it that I've gotten to see is that the majority of the leagues that are doing their thing, that are also all in cahoots with each other, they're not stepping on each other's toes, and they're not copying or mimicking anything that one other league is doing, at least in my opinion. You know what I'm saying? Everybody seems to be pretty authentic.
Yeah, everybody brings a certain piece to the table.
Yeah.
Yeah, but there's no reason for that, you know? Mm-hmm. It's enough for everybody to eat, mm-hmm. you know what I'm saying?
Big facts.
It would be unwise to do that to yourself in a league, in something designed where everybody could benefit off of each other.
Right.
You know? And the mixing and the, you know?
Big facts.
I think it only helps to be big a part facts. Of something bigger.
Well, let's get into the history. How did Brevard Battle Arena get started?
Okay. I wanted to battle. First and foremost, I wanted to battle for years. I used to go to Smack events back in the day, and if you're acquainted with back in the day, it wasn't no flyer, it wasn't no announcement. You would get a text.
It was a need to know.
You know what I'm saying? It's kind of like Fight Club, the movie. You get a text. If you didn't get the text, then you wasn't connected with somebody.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? Whether you knew somebody who knew somebody, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
It was like this super big group text that everyone used to get the location and the time. And, you know, that's I would show up. You know
that's
what I mean?
Crazy.
I would be part of that. You know what I'm saying?
And you're documented because you're in the background of so many different videos. It's wow, that's crazy. Yeah.
Facts.
But nah, I came to Florida, and I know Grind Time was out here at the time, and if I'm not mistaken, it was Grind Time was, I think, on his downhill. You know what I'm saying? Like towards the ending of Grind Time, and I wanted to be part of it, but I don't know. I guess the tryouts was like you had to pay for the tryouts.
Oh.
And I didn't like the idea of it being a tryout. I felt like if I'm gonna pay, then you know I should be able to
be a part of it.
Oh, okay. I'm not gonna pay somebody to try. You know, and not to talk, you know, negative about anybody, but that was just my personal opinion, you know what I'm saying? And in many ways, it kind of pushed me and influenced myself to say, you know what, why don't I just make my own thing? You know what I'm saying? Instead of driving, you know, how far away to pay and
yo,
to try out.
Yo, that's crazy, dude.
So, you know, and I'm cool with Matt Ills. I got mad love for Matt Ills.
Yeah,
we actually had him host our second event that we ever threw, and it was probably one of our biggest events that we ever threw, you know what I'm saying? Mad love to Matt Ills and Grind Time, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
But that's how I really started, you know. I wanted a battle, and I don't know. I like to be in control of things sometimes. Not like a control freak.
No, not negative.
But in you know, in order to do things the way I like to do them, you know what I'm saying? Sometimes I'll be on a different league, and the way they position their cameras, maybe I don't, you know, I don't like it. You know what I'm saying? And
even something as detailed as that, it's just
or
like
editing, or even editing, because I edit. Our video footage, you know what I'm saying? I literally control the camera. Like, I hire cameramen and I tell them exactly what I want them to do.
You're directing the show.
I'm directing everything.
Yeah,
you know what I'm
boss.
Saying? I'm designing the flyers, you know, I'm putting the card together. I'm literally, you know, calling every artist who's on the show just to make sure that everything is good in their life.
That's a feat all in itself.
Facts.
Up until the event, you know what I'm saying? Like, there's a lot of things that I kind of put into this to avoid, you know, a lot of negativity,
conflict,
or you know, things just not running smoothly. You know what I'm saying? So
you got your hands in every aspect of it.
Yeah, I wear a lot of hats. You know
facts.
What I'm
wow.
I definitely put it like that. You know what I'm saying?
Wow, that is crazy, man.
And it takes a lot, man. I actually thought about documenting a upcoming event just to show like the behind the scenes.
Yeah,
because
that
so happens to be.
You see Barrett bang his head against the wall
a couple times,
punch the door. Some
yeah,
shit.
Got changed the door like 3 times already. Like,
you know, not for nothing though.
Cereal launched out. Yo, I was gonna eat that.
Usually you need like a team,
yeah,
like a squad of people to do things. Otherwise, it's stressful. I got
Very much so.
Give a shout out to my wife Peb.
Shout out to
Peb. She really holds me down on the other. Whatever I don't do, she does. Whatever she don't do, I do. You know what I'm saying? So. Wow.
Shout out to wifey, man.
So
word
you guys
up.
Are like doing the job of, let's say, 5 to 6 or more people.
Definitely. Yeah. Most definitely.
And you got to raise a family.
And we're not like we try to be as professional as we can be.
Yes.
Like, we actually have contracts for every artist just to make sure that things are covered on our end,
yeah,
as well as theirs. You know what
right.
I'm saying?
So speaking of contracts, without getting into too much detail, because you know that's behind the scenes personal shit. How solidified are all the battles that are on this card?
We solidified.
On all of them?
Yeah, for the most part.
Okay, okay, okay. All right, that's what's up.
Yeah, it's going to be a good show, man.
Yeah, I can't wait. You know what I'm saying? I'm definitely
looking forward.
Strong card, man.
Yeah, this is a strong card, man. Yeah, I mean, to come back, you know what I'm saying? You got some shit, man. Like, yeah. I was like, okay.
Very surprising to see.
Oh, my man, it's for real. Yeah, I mean, shout to YBS and Jerz. They are going back and forth on their shit talking, which is really nice. Yeah. This is really good.
Yeah, no, I like that.
You know, Greedy and Hustle and Don Marino, they've been on the Gentlemen's. You know, they're keeping it classy San Diego.
But we know what they're coming with, though.
But we know that they're going to be very disrespectful.
We had Gritty and Dawn.
Yeah, but Gritty's courtesy of a completely unprofessional. He's not going to know any rap. I got to keep that going. My bad.
Yeah, right.
You know what I'm saying? And but I will say one thing. I don't know if I've caught anything from you and Drops yet. So that is a scary thing. Sometimes when I don't hear nothing, I'm like, damn, this is going to be really mean. Because these niggas are just so focused. They're like, facts. Fuck all the shit talking. I see you when I see you. Right, you know what I'm saying?
Straight up. Right. When's the last time you battled?
Last battle, maybe 3 years ago.
Oof.
Against Prez Mafia.
Okay.
New York.
Okay.
It was on Warzone.
I almost thought it was.
Yeah.
But it wasn't.
Oh, what?
Oh, no. I was thinking something after. I thought it was after.
I forgot you battled Prez out
actually,
there.
Actually, before, after Prime, the two major thing.
That was after? No.
Yeah.
I was going to. I thought it was Major. Yeah, was the
right.
last one.
Yeah. Bear Trap. He was no. The Bear Trap was after the amendment.
Yeah.
What Bear Trap was that?
The lab.
Oh, wow.
At the lab.
That was our second event ever. Right? On my birthday. Second.
Right? That was at the lab, right?
Second, on my physical birthday.
Event, the lab? At the
first
lab.
First Bear Trap.
Right.
First Bear Trap.
That was a good card.
That was a good card.
It was just hot as fucking there.
It was good.
It was definitely.
Caliente.
It was definitely
an enjoyable birthday. That was actually my birthday. Like,
it was definitely, yeah, definitely.
Was I there? I don't think.
No,
I was
no,
down.
You weren't there. But it was definitely hotter than Quest Wolf Nuts on a grill. I can promise you that shit was crazy.
Yeah, it was hot as fuck.
Yeah,
it was dope. But it was still a dope event. Yeah. So, but either way, we're glad that, you know, you're coming back. The league is coming back. You know what I'm saying? The energy is coming back. You know what I'm saying?
I'm excited, and at the same time, I'm exhausted. Because I've been doing so much work behind the scenes. It's crazy.
And you just moved.
Just moved, yeah.
Jesus.
Yeah. So. Well, blessings to you and the fam on all your future endeavors.
You just moved?
Blessings to the league.
I mean, I'm in town.
Oh, you're still in town? Okay.
Yeah.
Just going through the process of that. Yeah. You know what I'm saying?
That's strenuous.
You know what I mean? Writing bars, performing, work. You know what I mean? It's crazy.
You know what I'm saying?
But it's always good to have that support system.
Go to sleep. Listen to your mother. You know what I'm saying? Let's go out and catch. Throw the rock around.
We can't compliment that enough, though, having that support system.
Yo, man.
No.
What's the love been like online since you've announced coming back and showing the card?
It's excitement, bro.
I'm
handing flyers out to people every single day, and people already know about the event.
Hopefully they say we saw it on Check the Run.
They,
because you know I've been pushing some
been
ill
doing your thing with it,
some promo shits, man.
I think the promo's been doing great, man.
It's a combination of everything,
yeah?
Man.
Yeah, I agree.
Straight up.
I agree.
I just, you know, it's funny, something spoke to me inside and was like, I was God, obviously, but. You know, it was like, yo, you can do more with what you can do. You know what I'm saying? Because my schedule's so ridiculous. I can't always go out there and just. So I said, what can I do? And I was like, yo, you know what? As I talk about it and then I post it on YouTube, I edit just like you guys. You know, I'm one man on this too. And I was like, I'll just make sure the flyer pops up and then I'll just cut that.
I like the way
you've
been putting it up too.
You know what I'm saying?
That's fire. Yeah.
I noticed
the little things, I see it.
I know what you really like. You like how I had Scott. Dead and took one of his pics and shit, and I died that night. You love that shit.
Oh, yeah, that was funny. That was a good one.
We can't wait. Also, listen, I know it's about June 12th, but I ain't going to lie. We can fast for a little bit. June 27th, but I'm going to make sure that shit's a fucking movie, too.
Yeah, man. I'm going to be definitely in the building this time. There's no COVID holding me back.
You fucking around and catch COVID again.
Nah, I'm bringing COVID with me if that's the case.
It's going to be an online battle
Scott,
at that point.
Scott going to have to battle me and COVID.
He going to come in
It's gonna be a 2-on-1. It's gonna be me and COVID versus Scott.
You're gonna come in a radioactive suit.
Yeah, I'm gonna be looking like the outbreak dude. Like,
I could just see
Vader.
Cortez, like, the CDC is gonna see this. Well, you know, if Barry goes on a show, he could actually say, I know there's a couple niggas in there that had.
Oh, yeah,
COVID,
exactly.
Saying.
It wouldn't be him ruining it this time.
I think I caught COVID at one of my events, to be honest.
Oh, shit.
There we go.
But, oh, whatever. Jesus. It's all. Yeah.
I I mean, it was my event.
We survived. I probably had COVID, too. We probably all had COVID for all we know. You know what I'm saying?
Before it came out.
I think everybody's going to cuss that shit.
I had to run.
I mean, it's an inevitability at this point. It's not going nowhere.
I made it.
Exactly. We're all going to catch it.
Like, yeah.
But blessings to everybody that dealt with COVID, dealing with COVID, or have overcome it.
Yeah.
You know?
No. Seriously, yeah. And for those that didn't overcome it, rest in peace and our condolences to the friends and family that lost anyone associated with this, pandemic, man.
Right.
So I'll tell you what, man. We're doing a new segment here. You know, everyone knows Fuego's Unnecessary, Necessary News, and that comes on, every time she gets this... this twitch in her neck that she just got to say something and shit.
Necessary.
You like that shit,
right? Because sometimes it's
Important
to her, but...
Yeah. Sometimes
it's vital information.
Yeah, that's why it's unnecessary and necessary. Cause sometimes it is unnecessary. I'd be like, okay, honey. And the other time I'd be like...
You're saying it like either or.
Right. It's unnecessary and necessary.
Unnecessary. Oxymoron.
Yeah. However you want to take it.
Yeah, you can kind of throw it out there, too. It's all good. You know how we... Okay, listen. I know we're a group of men, and, sorry, Fuego, but you know how when women be like, babe, this, that, and there, and we're like, but in our mind, we're like, who gives a fuck? But it's necessary, right? Because they want that. Right. But every once in a while, they'll say some shit, and we're like, who gives a fuck? Oh, wait. Okay. Oh, shit.
They just
put
us on to something. Like, wait, what?
Yeah.
Where you heard that?
Fuego's Unnecessary, Necessary News.
I like it, though. It works.
Yeah, it's going to work. So we're gonna take a break. We're going to get into a Casino 183rd featuring King Arthur. This one's amazing. You know what I'm saying? And when we come back, we're going to do a quick, Fuego Unnecessary, Necessary News. And then we get back to, what grown men talk about.
That's what's up.
So it's all love. You already know what it is. CTR23, Check the Rhyme Radio. Josh Dallas.
Yo.
Casino 183rd. Lou Berra. Favorite Puerto Rican GQ, the Embassy. Let's get it popping, y'all. Cheers. Salute.
World a better place. When I see that smile on your face, there ain't a person in this world who can take your place. You're beautiful in your body, I wanna penetrate. You've been number one in my life since our first date. Your soulmates ain't no question, cause this is fate. Our destiny is together through the sun and rain, fun and pain, from being broke and reaching fame. I changed since I met you, nothing's been the same. I love the way that you talk and how you say my name. You ain't afraid to show love because you ain't ashamed. And you don't care what people think or what they say. They wanna be like us, baby, so let them hate. They just mad, they can't relate to what we demonstrate. They can imitate what we have, but we ain't playing games. There's no comparison to us, so let's just celebrate. Close the door, lock it, and lay you down to get your face. With you in my life, by my side, with you in my life, with you in my life. My life is amazing, with you by my side, with you in my life. You are a blessing, so I thank God every day for all that you do and the things you say. The way you cooking this food and how you serve my plate, taking care of the kids when I go to work every day. It's the little things that count more than anything. You're my partner in life, and you're my strength. Made me into a better man than I used to be. Just a touch of your kiss, you don't know what you do to me. What's a king without his queen? Checkmate. We like Bonnie and Clyde, cause we ain't fake. We have a beautiful life, and what we have is great. And your quality time's what I appreciate. I just wanted you to know how much you mean to me. When I look in your eyes, it feels just like a dream, like a fantasy that I ain't ever seen. Amazing. With you in my life, my life is amazing. With you by my side, with you in my life. Oh, it's on you.
Cheer, cheer, cheer. Salute, salute, salute. You already know what it is. It's your boy Josh Dollars. When I'm not doing what I do, which is hosting, rapping, or what have you, I'm checking out my favorite sort of rhythm, GQ to MC. Holla at me and check the rhymes. Yeah.
Cheer, cheer, cheer. Salute, salute, salute. You already know what it is. Favorite sort of rhythm, GQ to MC. We are back, and we have the beautiful Fuego's Unnecessary News. What's up, baby? How you doing?
What's up?
Chilling.
How are you?
We're going to get fly on this mic. You know what I'm saying? I'm going to help you. I'm
an ally. Do y'all need a moment?
I can
leave.
We always need a moment. Nah, but it's all good. So we're going to start a segment that's going to correspond to her name, given by yours truly. I got to take credit. I'm so sorry. But you know what I'm saying? What do we got today on the chopping block for Fuego's unnecessary news? Speak close into the mic.
Well, we've been listening to DMX a lot, his new album.
Mm-hmm.
But of course, you know, he talks about one song in particular, Jay-Z, when he talks about, you know, the Kardashians.
I know, and that took in a bad way.
It did.
Why did it hit you so bad, baby?
Because everybody's quick to put her down.
Oh. You're right.
I take it personal.
And then they make a video about when they put her down. You know what I'm saying?
How did you feel about that?
Which one, the movie or the statement?
No, not the movie.
Sorry.
And it wasn't a movie.
You're damn right, it wasn't. It was a documentary.
Pretty close.
Have you seen it?
No, I haven't.
You never saw the Ray J and Kim show?
I mean, I saw a video of them before, but it wasn't that.
Pretty beautiful, actually.
Yeah. What video are you talking about?
I thought it was like, the porno, man. I got it.
Oh, okay. Yeah.
Shit.
Stop speaking in code. Yeah, man. Let's be for real.
My bad. I was trying to be politically correct.
I thought there was an additional video. Like,
that's old, man. That's old.
Yeah, I know, but
that's
it was
almost like a classic.
It is a classic. I'm glad you said that.
You ain't see that. You
know what I'm saying? One time for that shit. It's a classic. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah,
facts.
But it's also, and not to be so disrespectful, but you know, I always felt like it was her come up. Bar. But I'm just saying. But you know, we're not the only one that thought that.
My dog is a rapper.
Exactly.
You
know, exactly.
That's what we do here. So apparently Jay-Z had something to say about it too.
The come up.
You know what I'm saying? And Jay-Z's line, I'm gonna just say the line. It says, Come be my Kardashian, queen of the come up. Mm. You know what I'm saying?
I didn't even catch
that. You know how you tied that in there.
How is the living? Coca-Cola, the sponsor. I run up with your boo. Hove is a monster. Yeah. They like me like that. Every girl I see wanna be wifey like that. I'm the king of Zamunda, king of the summer. Come be my Kardashian, queen of the come up. To
Man,
be loved.
That's kind of crazy because he cool with Kanye and they got their little.
It's a weird thing because
that's a weird relationship.
But
falling out was a falling.
That's what I'm saying. I always heard of that of them having a falling out, and I was like, that's damn, son.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
I mean, they were together at the Diddy's party. Who, you know?
Yeah, but for someone to say that I would take that a certain way if I heard that bar. About my
her been
the mother of my children, yeah. You know, like
yeah. Like
keep that out of your reps,
yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
I can definitely dig that. You know what I'm saying? You know,
how far is too far when you get to that kind of? How many people are actually listening to this music and doing what we're doing?
Right now,
say that again.
Say it to the mic. The mic.
It's nasty between him and Kim right now, so I don't think he cares what's being said.
That's what I'm thinking. I'm thinking like he's sticking up for his homie.
Right.
I mean,
you know what I'm saying?
What did he really say? Was it that crazy?
And what has she really?
Oh, let's go. Let's go.
Hold on. I want to play devil's advocate. I want to play. What has she really done negatively to Kanye for her to be the one receiving this kind of backlash? Like,
and if she did, it's probably behind the scenes and not our business.
That's a fact. That's a fact. That is a fact.
Marital issues, you know.
Yeah.
He doesn't like to be publicized anyway. He's running from cameras, dodging stop signs, and
here's a question.
You know,
again, Jay's just stating facts.
Yeah, I mean, but sometimes the facts.
Hove got his
still,
own marital issues
that's
that
what
he
I'm saying.
Dealt with.
I mean, he needs to worry
on
about
record.
He needs to worry about Solange. He needs to take, you know, boxing class.
He was taking taekwondo kicks.
You know what I'm saying?
He spoke on it too.
But I mean, he's speaking on his own stuff to try to take shots at somebody else's wife. You know, that's I don't know. It's kind of a little whack. I think it's a little
whack. What was the bargain?
It was, he said, I'm the king of Zamunda, king of the summer. Come be my Kardashian, queen of the come up.
How far can we really take that bar into, like...
It's not that crazy.
But it's still, but it references.
It's still a shot.
It references it's the still sex. A shot, yeah. Yeah. But I guess shot. He's like, listen, I'm just.
But
I'm just,
all know what it is.
I'm just quoting the obvious. I'm quoting the obvious. She put a sex tape out there and.
But at the same time, why mention it, though? Why say it?
Because he's Hove.
That is true.
No, I don't give a fuck about that Hove
yeah,
shit.
He's Hove.
That doesn't mean anything to me.
He runs the industry right now. This nigga is
there's a listen. There's a meticulous reason for everything. It's damn not right. just a it wasn't just him saying something. This is on the DMX album.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? This was definitely going to get played. This was going to get heard, especially after God knows how long X and Hove been on the same track. You know what
and
I'm
they've
saying?
Had their issues too,
right? Because there was always a debate
yes.
over them too.
Mm-hmm.
But just for the bar to be said, you know, it takes
it's weird.
It's very weird. It leaves a bad taste.
And how would it have been received if Kanye would have said some shit about Beyonce?
Right.
And when do you stop bringing that up?
Yeah.
Right.
That is
when
true.
is it done hearing about that? You know what I mean?
That is true.
Know.
Yeah. Well, definitely, it's very necessary. You know what I'm saying? Is there anything else that you want to get onto the chopping block, Vanessa?
So you guys probably? Have, but you guys have heard the entire DMX
yes,
album. What's
yes.
your thoughts on that?
I think the album is dope. I think there was like one song or two that weren't really moving. One in particular that I was like, the feature was absolutely garbage. And then I forgot another one that we just heard. That
the
I was
one
like,
with Alicia Keys is fire.
Alicia Keys dope. I like the one with Griselda
I think
the
that's
most.
That's my favorite one. The one with Alicia.
I just wish they
did Nas joint. Oh yeah, that but on the DMX album.
I
on
just
the DMX.
Wish
the Nas, yeah, the Nas joint was fire.
There's a song with Jay-Z, Nas, and DMX, and they go back and forth.
That's fire.
Yeah,
right.
That one's dope. That one's
that
dope.
One's hard.
The Griselda joint was fire.
The Griselda joint is dope. I just wish they would actually use
the
beat, not a fucking sample. You know what I'm saying?
Oh, gotcha. Oh,
I mean, it's fire anyway. Then that sample's been overused, in my opinion.
Then the letter to my son
that was too much.
Shit,
that was too much.
I wasn't ready for that. I was driving. I was trying to suck every damn tear in my face.
I couldn't do it.
It.
I do feel your point. Like there's some joints on there that's like, and it makes me wonder. Damn, but is it because it's passing and they rushed it? They obviously rushed this shit.
Yeah, there's some things that
because it dropped. Not even a month.
Nah, it was already done.
He was in promo mode.
No, there's interviews where he mentioned the album was already done.
Yeah, right. Exactly.
And
yeah,
he already said it was done.
He also
done.
Said the album had a lot of features. Mm-hmm. So that was his moment.
He was on
to
his promo
back.
Run. He did the Nori thing.
You know,
he was doing interviews.
Touch base with all the generations.
Yes.
You know what I'm saying? Because he got one with Wayne on there.
That was dope.
That
Bono was fire. The one with Bono was fire, too.
I like that one. Skyscrapers.
Skyscrapers.
That one was hard.
That caught me off guard. I didn't even see that coming.
That was
hard. Yeah, man. I was like,
it was not. Okay, I'm going to put it like this. I like the album.
It's a senior.
Not what
it's
I expected.
Senior album.
Got you.
Well, but
mean,
you know what? You know, you got a point.
It's a senior album.
You got a point.
Come on, man.
It's got a point. If Hulk could do it.
I don't even look at it like that. It's like you got to look at it. I'm sorry.
Go ahead.
I was gonna say you got to look at it like, all right, you bringing up Hove. Look where Hove is in his life.
That's what I was.
Look where. Look at the direction Hove went. Look at where X was, and was at the time of making this album. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
That's. I'm looking at it from perspective. Like X went a whole nother direction in his life. He was still fighting personal things. He was still. Going through it and to hear the music where he was at, that's what I'm looking for. Like, I'm looking for my MCs that I look up to be telling me their truth, their journey, their life through their music, you know?
Mm-hmm.
So it was a pleasure to hear him at that age, you know, still standing with the big dog, showing respect to the new blood, like you were saying.
Right. He still sounds like the classic.
And
DMX.
He's still classic X, you know?
Yeah. The one that you're referring to, Casino, is the one, the Bath Salts. That's the one that I'm referencing.
Bath Salts.
Yeah, word. Yeah. That's the one right there.
Yeah, that's a crazy.
I'm
track.
So glad that Hove and Nas made the album.
Yeah, me too.
I didn't expect that.
To make his album?
Especially if the album was done while he was alive. Because look how many albums he dropped prior. You know what I'm saying? It's crazy that they just. It just so happened that all these features and shit, he passed away.
I mean, that's how God works, man.
You know what I'm saying? Like, think about that. You know what I'm saying? Like, if the album was truly done, you know what I'm saying? Which it definitely was.
He spoke
in
on
that
it,
case
yeah.
because they did drop it fast. Yeah. Like all these features, all these, you know, Hov and people that he worked with when he first was popping and all that.
Mm-hmm.
The track, you know, with the locks was fire.
He had a bunch of albums that.
That was crazy.
And now, you know, it just worked. It just. made sense. Like, I don't know. That's weird.
I think it's all about timing, man. It's all about timing.
Did you guys ever hear that letter to my son?
Yeah, man. I
What is your thoughts on that? Because when he says, like, you know, we could have been better. We could. Something about mending it before he dies and all this other crap. I was just like, shit, nigga.
It's deep.
This is fucked.
I heard it. I'm thinking of the, there was like an MTV show, I think, one time where one of his sons tried to reach
Yo,
out to him.
Yo, I saw that shit with the mediator, with that other chick. Yeah.
Or some shit like that. And that's the only thing I could think
he
of.
He started wigging out on that chick, you know?
Yeah, yeah, it was wild.
Holy shit.
I think to me personally, you just get that. I don't know, because, you know, everybody deals with drugs in their family and, you know, people dealing with alcohol abuse, drug abuse. So that's how it touched me, you know, because that's involved in a lot of personal issues, you know? So to hear that song and to have personal history with stuff like that,
that hit something like different with you. I got
so
you.
It resonated completely, like,
wow,
like I almost called that number, you know what I'm saying?
Yo, like, that when he dropped that number was. I was like, Jesus Christ, bro, you about to, this nigga's about to make me fucking cry,
like,
right
I
now
almost, like I kind of hope that
right
he
now
did mend it with his son, you know?
I believe
yes
so.
Yes,
and what, so if wait, he, what if he didn't though, you know?
Facts.
Oh man, that's gonna kill his son.
That's what I'm saying, man.
I mean, but yes, that's what God is for. God is the middleman in that aspect, you know? Like,
well,
if you ever feel like you can't speak to a loved one, just know that if you do pray, it does reach them. So
I think the beauty about
it is never too late, as the song
Exodus, if that his son's name's Exodus, right? I believe the beauty of,
I think it was his daughter.
Well, that means it says letter. Isn't it say Exodus? Letter to my son, Exodus?
I think that was just referencing the name of the album.
I think so.
Oh, I'm sorry. You're probably right. I'm so sorry. Yeah, so his son, I forgot what his name is. But nonetheless, I believe that with him, the beautiful part about that will be the fact that his mother is so grounded that I know that anything that he has that's bothering him, she'll be able to reconfirm. Listen, your father battled with a lot of demons, and yes, even though you guys did have your situation, he loved you enough to write a song.
That's what I'm saying. Like, hearing is like, damn, it feels good to see that he finally came around.
Yes, man.
Because watching that footage was kind of harsh.
Yo,
I've never seen the footage,
bro,
that you're speaking,
like,
about.
What is it, like two or three parts or some
live
shit?
Like, I don't know if it was live. It was,
bro,
a show.
It's
MTV,
a, yeah,
where you meet, like, rekindle.
Right.
You know,
so,
you know,
yeah, I don't know the lady's name. I don't know the lady's name, but she had the show.
Was it on
just
some
like
type of
Casino
therapy
was saying,
shit?
It's something like that, that, where the son was trying to just be like, listen, confront DMS. Like, look, yo,
it's
like
a therapy.
Stop,
like,
drugs.
Yeah, stop the drugs.
I want to
be,
your life.
Yes,
I want to be your son.
Yeah.
I want a hug. I want love. And he was just like, nah, this is who I am.
They're right, and that's the part that was really heartbreaking. He's like, listen, I'm your father. You know what I'm saying? I don't have to stop smoking weed or stop drinking to be your father. Like, this is crazy. And so he's trying to have a conversation, and she, of course, as a therapist, and, you know, for the show, I guess, she's trying to interject, and he's like, yo, I'm not talking to you.
Mm-hmm.
Like, I'm talking to him. And this could have all been resolved behind the scenes. I have to be on this show to do this type of stuff.
Mm-hmm.
So he was very defensive, taken back.
He was 98. That's what he was, man.
You know what I'm saying?
He was 98.
Yeah.
You know, we grew up on a different cloth.
Yeah,
you know what
man
I'm saying? And when, I don't know if you've heard this saying recently, with the newer generations of today being a little more weaker than the old school generation.
Yeah, of course.
You know what I'm saying? But he was 98. He was the old him. He ain't changed not one bit. And it seemed like his son was obviously the newer generation, and everybody wants to pull out a, you know, therapist.
Yes.
You know, and back in the day, it was just so much hardcore that
I got to deal with it. That's it.
Yeah,
exactly.
We had
to deal with it. You know, that's the situation in life.
All right. Well, since we here right now, let's get into that. Do you think that hurts us ultimately, though? Being that tough and being so shield up, sword out all the time, and not coming down.
I think it hurts.
And
I think so because I think you need to talk about it. You can't hold it in.
I think it hurts the generation that it affects. Sorry, not to cut you off, Fuego, but I think, I don't think it hurts if I'm talking to someone that I understand that type of way of being. If I just get out, you're like, yo, my nigga, bet. You know what I'm saying? Nothing else has to be said. I get it. We're good.
Because I'm seeing where Casino's coming from, because we got parents that are that. Wow. That we seen them hard and. You know what I'm saying? The love is weird how they showed it, when they did, how they did.
Right.
You know what I mean?
Right.
And we took it how we could because we the child, you know?
Yeah,
we don't know how else to
take
perceive
it. Yeah,
right.
That passes down to us because, like, our parents, we used to look at them like they crazy.
Facts.
They look at us like, you know, what kind of music you listening to?
Yeah, exactly, yeah.
We become that. And now Word. Our kids are looking at us like we the crazy ones, and we're looking at what kind
and look at how much look yeah. how much look how much music and stuff it's like just, that evolves.
It's just a cycle, man.
Yeah,
it is a cycle.
You know, I do believe us being more hardcore prepared us for what society has in the world, as opposed to now you're getting a lot more kids killing themselves. Wasn't there another rapper that? Rapper's friend or brother that got shot and killed like a couple days ago, like a day or two ago or something like that.
Oh,
like
man.
One of these new rappers.
Okay.
I think I saw a post earlier that said Lil Durk's brother passed away.
Oh, wow. They're just killing each other off or they, you know,
crazy.
Offing themselves, you know.
Yeah.
Did you hear about, what's the battle rapper's name? That was in Dipset. His daughter was missing.
Oh, yeah. I heard about that.
Who's that? 40 Cal?
Oh, 40 Cal? Word?
Did you hear about that?
Nah,
I don't want to say a name, and it's not
right.
He's the only one in Dipset that I knew battled.
Oh wow! Body. Apparently, her boyfriend left her, and she couldn't take it. The heartbreak, and she killed herself.
Oh,
and they found the body.
Man.
It was like,
yo,
weeks.
So she was missing for like 2 weeks.
Damn, son.
Yeah. And I remember, I think I shared the post too.
But that's what I'm saying, though. Like, you know, I mean, our generation.
That's crazy,
though. We all went through some type of heartbreak that killed us.
Right.
It's the end of the world. I don't know what to do. But we had to fight through it, and that's what made us who we are. And without that, we'd be either dead or soft.
Like, they don't understand.
So like, my point is, though, looking at love that we were getting from our parents and then being able to tell ourselves, okay, this is love, and then doing that same thing to our children, is that helping?
No.
Transferring
it's not.
That?
No, it's not. It's not.
We
are we taking the good or are we seeing the bad and flipping it?
Well, we're trying to make it better.
Right. Well, we're doing, because I've had that same situation with my kids. You know, I got three kids aside from, you know, our 13-year-old that we have to deal with constant, you know, praise. You know what I'm saying? Because we got to make sure that she understands. But, you know, before Fuego and I got together, you know what I'm saying? I was married before and I got three kids outside of what we're, you know, where our family is. And all three of my kids, Destiny, Fabian, and Angel, you know what I'm saying? They can be like, you know, Dad, you spazzed out a lot about this and this, that, and third. And I'm over here like, yo, but I spoke to y'all after that. You know what I'm saying? I explained it. But they don't understand that when I was coming up and I got spazzed on, there was no explanation.
Yeah.
It was, that's the spazzing.
Right.
Does it suck? Sucks to be you. Right. Now get your ass up. And I don't want to see no face. Can't have a bad day.
Mm-mm.
Don't be grumpy just to be grumpy. Mm-hmm. And definitely don't be grumpy based on what I just told you.
Right.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, it is what it is. And
there goes my mom, man. There goes my daddy. And, you know, we had to sing and dance that shit. Where today, if you tell your kid the only thing, like, yo, my nigga, calm down. They like, yo, sweetheart, you relax. You know what I'm saying? And you're just like, yo, what the fuck is you upset about, my nigga? I'm just talking to you. You know what I'm saying? And there's so much social media shit now that now they're
that's what he was getting into, the bullying.
That's what I blame it on. I blame it on, you know, social media and society, whatever's being put out there in the world. You know what I mean?
Well, kids think they're entitled to everything, bro. Oh, this kid got the newest phone. How come I can't have that? I'm abused. I didn't get the newest phone. And I'll be like,
I mean, that ties in back to
you
being looked at in school with what you have possessionally.
Right.
You know what I'm saying?
So, and that's always
if you don't have it, you get
so
judged.
Tigers,
you know?
On my shirt. You know, alligators. You
know what I'm saying?
I see you
later. You know what I'm saying? Word up.
Drama.
Facts.
Bow. Why you punch me in my
stay in your place. You know what I'm saying?
Is real.
I'll be like, oh, you want that new
but
shit?
I think it's just so much more. Because I got bullied as a kid.
I'm going to get you the Gordon Cottrell.
I ain't had the best clothes as a kid. You know what I'm saying? Growing up, you got picked on. You got ragged because of your shoes. All of that.
Word
but it's that mental toughness that you got. You're either going to be a victim of it or you're going to stand up and be like, nah, you know?
Yo, it's crazy? Real quick, I'll cut you off. I'll be buying shoes and Frag will be like, yo, babe, you know, you just got like three pairs just last week.
You have a serious problem.
Right, shut up.
Sneakerhead.
I don't have a serious problem. I'm just sneakerhead. But what I tell you, I say
he's working on his museum.
That's it, right? Say that again.
You always wanted them.
That's it. I'll be like, yo, but I always wanted them when
he's
I was
he's putting
kid.
The sneakers on the younger GQ.
You know what I'm saying? Right. Facts.
Mental.
It's crazy how, I'm just thinking about what you just said, and it's crazy how back in the day, that was a big deal. Where like the clothing you wore. Like that was a really.
But
I remember
but peep this.
Out.
Before you would just get picked on, and it would be that circle. that would ha-ha you.
Yeah.
Now, I turn this camera on, all 500 of my friends are laughing at you.
That's crazy. Wide world,
it's so much more amplified.
That's true.
Oh, my God, they embarrass me online. It's forever. And then I go to the extreme. You know, it's just like,
and then it comes up as a memory.
Oh my God.
you ever seen
Michael Blackston talk about that?
Nah.
He said when he first came to America,
he
got ragged on, you know, because in Africa, you know, your clothes just had to be clean. He didn't care about none of that, you know.
Okay.
Then when he came to the States, a name brand was a name brand. Right. But then he figured out, oh, it matters whose name it is. And he was just like, yo, but this is this and this is that. And they're like, nah, but you still look like you just got off the boat and all of that. And
he's
just like, what the fuck is these sheep?
More that soccer.
But he had a good perspective of it because where he came from, you barefoot. It was just nice to have shoes.
Facts.
But then coming over here, now it's like, oh, whose shoes are they? And he's like, it doesn't matter. They're new. They're shoes. Like, I was just barefoot. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. So,
nigga, like, I was just hopping up to have ashy feet.
Right.
Now I have to have the new Yeezys. So, what were you going to say? Because I feel it's itching to come out here. I don't know what it is, and I'm probably going to regret it later.
Can we say why?
With the social media?
Shoes? No, why do you want those shoes?
Oh, we back on the shoes.
Oh, we back on the shoes. This is.
Let's talk about
she never left.
No, I
you know what I'm saying? She stood.
She was there.
Oh, well, we're here now. Let's get it.
I can't get over wearing, like, church shoes to school on gym day.
Yo, you ain't shit.
Church shoes.
Yo, so my mom, check this out. Shout out to my mom. My mom used to have me switch up. One day be sneakers, the other day would have to be shoes.
Ugh.
I'm over here busting my ass wearing shoes, playing,
yo,
playing basketball.
Why would she do that?
I don't know. Gotta ask my mom. Mom, why would you do
she
that?
At least, dress
mom
your
is
shoes
a watcher of the show. Hey, mom.
The gym. That's crazy.
She would wild out, so I would always be mad. I'd be like, yo, my feet are killing me.
You just had to be a little smarter and throw the sneakers in the bag, baby.
No, my mother was not. My mom drove me. She was none of that.
I would have had a pair of sneakers in a locker or something. Yeah. Somewhere
this is before lockers. Once we got to lockers, I was straight.
Man, Biggie had a treasure chest on the
right.
Yo, that's a fact.
Oh, shit. I remember that.
Yo, real.
Where you get the treasure chest from in New York?
Like, you know what I'm saying? Like,
yeah. Big nigga on a roof changing clothes.
Word up, man. Once we got to the lockers and I was good, thank God. But it took me a while to plead my case and to win. You know what I'm saying? Because that was I think my daddy had to be like, yo, what are you doing?
Seeing
I think the hardest thing to me was explaining it. Like, no, I have to have these kind of shoes. Because if I go to school with
to
this.
Make sure my kids got J's.
You know what I'm saying? You know? Now, my mother was like, no, we're going to keep these sneakers looking fresh the whole year.
And then you see them thrown around. Man, what you doing?
Yo, my son Angel was like that. Be throwing himself around. I'm like, nigga, what's wrong with you, nigga? You ain't wearing sweatpants.
Walking, dragging the toe.
You should lean in.
Yo, that's crazy.
Word, like, son.
Who taught you who's walking like that?
Like a penguin?
You take those off.
You got a penguin as a step parent somewhere?
As soon as they put on the tennis shoes, they already knew. Like, we're going to start.
Yeah.
They couldn't get them dirty.
Yeah.
They would cry to me. Cry. If they got them dirty, they would come crying because they knew they're going to get in trouble.
Yeah.
I seen dirty.
Oh, that's why I make my daughter clean her shoes. I buy a nice little shoe cleaning clip, you know?
Yeah.
I would buy
drag your feet. You gonna brush them.
I would get my kids dark color sneakers. You know what I'm saying? The whites. I'm like, y'all niggas ain't ready for that. Yeah, you ain't ready for that shit.
Dirt is dirt, baby.
You know what I'm saying? Yeah, but white on dirt was crazy.
That's why I let you live.
Yo, but yeah, thanks for bringing that up, Fuego. But on the ill for all the niggas. But all the niggas that ball with me. Now you know why I was wetting y'all niggas up from 30 feet away. Cause I can't go inside with them shoes.
My nigga had the Jesus 3s on.
You know what I'm saying?
He was smoking y'all from the 3-point line.
Shit.
But imagine if he had some Jordans on.
He'd have been dunking on.
Oh, it depends. If it was Monday, Wednesday, Friday, I'm taking you to the hole. Tuesday, Thursday,
I'm arching you.
I'm Larry Birding you to death, nigga.
Because he was going home hurt.
Yo, what?
Dogs was barking.
Only 8-year-old with corns on his.
My 5-year-old gets some baby wipes and he starts wiping his J's off.
That's how you do it.
He had to understand the importance.
He be like, yo, daddy, look, I'm matched today.
Word
up. He's already on the way.
Yo, that's crazy. I tell you what, let's thank you, Fuego, for embarrassing me. And now my mom's probably going to block you.
Well, maybe she'll call me now.
Oh, Lord. There we go. Always taking shots. And that was Fuego's one-time unnecessary news. Hey, it's all good. We appreciate
you. Look forward to more segments like that.
Without blowing my spot or my mother's spot, but it's all good. Nah, just kidding. It's all love. So let's get into this. Let's get into this shit. We're probably gonna get shut down, but we don't give a fuck here.
Hey.
Since we're talking about DMX, why not promote the album? You know what I'm saying? We're gonna help.
Word.
Swiss, not for nothing. Let me live, nigga. Let us live over here because we're helping the movement. So let's get into it. Is there any napkins or shit? Because we might all be crying after this one. This was
you playing that one?
Letter to my son. Oh, let's just get into it. CTR23, Check the Bomb Radio. Cheers, salute. We love y'all.
One of those, you ain't know what it is. Dear son, look in your eyes to see my own. You look in my eyes to see my throne. Many times I tried to talk to explain to you. See, it didn't mean a thing. Love you, but right now I wanna bite you. Wanna give you a hug, but I might bite you. Might be a man about it, we can admit when we're wrong. Come on! Get off that kid shit you are. You done paid attention, you done saw it coming. But you a man looking through the eyes of a woman. Always don't love your mama, we always just drifted apart. And my kids, y'all my heart. And you got more brothers and sisters, it's cause I got more kids. And hey, it's just what it is. You the oldest, I've known you longer, but I don't love them less. Had to get that off my chest. And I don't know what you thought about my use of drugs, but it taught you enough to not use the drugs. When you were a kid, you played with toys, okay? But you a man, put them toys away. But I'm saying it, stop thinking like a child. Cause what if it's when I'm gone that you realize it wrong? That we could have been best of friends all along. Kind of defeat the purpose of this song. 917-915-4804. Give me a call, I love you boy. That's the truth. Call me.
Cheers, Slu. Y'all know it is. Favorite Puerto Rican GQ to Embassy. I mean, Jesus, man. That one always brings something out. You know what I'm saying?
That was deep, man.
Yeah, it's not like a bunch of verses and stuff like that. It's like...
That's when music transitions right there.
Yeah.
It's like just beyond music, you know?
Fact,
it's,
man.
It's a little bit more than just...
That's what's missing in the game, you know? The soul.
You know what's crazy, man?
Did any one of y'all ever get to see X perform live?
No, not live.
Nah,
live.
I
got to be in his presence, but I didn't get to see him live.
Only pay-per-view was that.
Yeah.
You were there amongst him?
Yeah, went with when I was the extra at Belly with the church scene. You know, it was amazing to see him, you know, basking in the attention that he was getting and the fans and all that shit. You know what I'm saying? Me and my niggas was like, yo, son, look at that nigga. We seen the Boomer tattoo on the back because, you know, that nigga like still without the shirt. You know what I'm saying? And it was dope. You know, we was like, damn, you know what I'm saying? And we just aspired. We was like, yo, one day, you know what I'm saying? One of us or all of us, we going to be in some type of position that, you know, we going to be revered. You know what I'm saying? So, you know, but nah, I never got to. You know, I heard stories from Pun. You know what I'm saying? Pun used to always tell me how ill he was whenever they would, you know, link up.
That cypher with them at that table.
Yeah.
That's always good.
Because I would ask questions. Because I would be like, yo, how's this nigga? And this, I'm not going to name names, but I'd be like, yo, that nigga's real. I'd be like, yo, what about that nigga? I'm like, that nigga pussy. That nigga Pun was wild like that. You know what I'm saying?
Bet. Yeah.
But X was someone that he looked up to as far as, you know, New York rap. You know what I'm saying? And he was like, yo, X is a real nigga. You know what I'm saying? He's ridiculous. You know what I'm saying? So, but you got to see him perform live.
No, I wish.
Oh, okay,
man, that would have been
The most. Listen, we're all.
The energy
we're all artists, so that would have been inspiring. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
You know what I'm saying?
Did y'all see Hove talk about when X went on before him?
Yeah.
And the interview.
Yeah. That's X in a nutshell right there. Like that energy. You know what I'm saying?
He was
straight, raw. Like
X. I'm telling you, X was the first and only artist on a secular level, right? That showed me that, you know, real men pray.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? Real men pray. And then as an artist, you know what I'm saying? You know, we tend to do shows, we do our shows, we trying to be all fly and shit like that. X was the only, not the first, but the only artist that showed me full humility is fly.
Yeah.
Because you're a real artist when you're really, you're really expressing. When you're just there licking your lips trying to be fly, you're just modeling. You know what I'm saying?
Right, but when
you're there and you got a song that's deep, right, and you's doing that and you licking your lips trying to be fly for the ladies, you just did a deep joint and that shit don't even move you. How the fuck is it gonna, you expect it to move anybody else? And it wasn't for show. It was literally therapy for him to be able to just come out there. I mean, I seen him do a show at a group home that he was once at. And he broke down so bad, you know what I'm saying, that I was like, at first I was like, oh, this is a disaster. But it had nothing to do with it being a disaster or a hit show. It had everything to do with him having his moments of release this energy.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? I mean,
X closure for him.
X is the only nigga that would make thugs cry. Right. You know what I'm saying?
There was a fine line to what he did involving, you know, his real life,
right,
rap, religion. He's probably one of the only rappers I know to be able to fuse them and have that perfect match.
Absolutely.
You know what I'm saying?
Behind the scenes, people say, or at the award show, yo, first I want to thank God. And that's great, no doubt. But you knew God was a part of his everyday. You know, but you also knew that he also was fighting with his demons as well.
Right. Mm-hmm.
So it was like he was our sacrifice to be able to see his goods and his bads and his uglies. He didn't have a problem showing you him falling or showing you how to get back up.
Mm-hmm.
That's the biggest form of humility that most people, forget about artists, most people can't even do that in their life.
Well, that's what made him who he was, you know? As far as an artist, as a person, somebody that we gravitated to musically and stuff like that. Yeah. So,
I mean, it's because of X that when he passed away and we did the dedication show, I was able to cry during prayer.
Yeah, man, still.
And
still
people that know me,
man,
know I don't do that.
Still bothers me.
Right, yo, absolutely.
X fucked me up. He really did like that. Him passing away, that whole week was whack.
Still, I'm still.
Fucked up. I mean, come on, we're people that really. Some people say, well, how can you cry for someone that you don't know? Well, nigga, that's you then. You know what I'm saying? But that
person, was a part of your life. Well, at least, I'm speaking for me.
Me too, yeah.
He was a part of my daily routine in a sense of just when I was at a certain point in my life.
Yeah.
Like, he filled a gap. You know,
people that understood his music, you can't tell them that we didn't know him. He may have not known us.
Right, we definitely
knew him.
Exactly.
Yeah. You know what I'm saying? And that's what made me.
You know, I connected with X too. I lived in Yonkers. I've been to School Street. I know Getty Square. I've been to Warburton. I lived off of Warburton. Lox was literally the next block over. I would see them chilling on the street all the time. I seen X in the hood.
Been to the D Block gas station.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, the infamous D Block gas station.
You know what I'm saying? So, I connect with that. You know what I'm saying? That dude, when I tell you he put Wire on his back, yo, like it's an understatement.
If you haven't heard the album, please download it, stream it, buy it, whatever you got to do.
And hear it a few times, though. Hear it a few times, because maybe the first initial time you might be like, that's fine. Let me tell you something.
I liked it, man.
The new Nas album, the first time I heard it, I thought it was trash.
Right.
I did. Come the third time, I was like, who the fuck am I?
Right.
You know what I'm saying? I needed therapy with myself. Like, listen, you need help. You know what I'm saying? Now I'm like, this shit is crazy.
Well, like,
what? Yes.
I
was like, this shit is crazy. Yeah. In the car, you know, we listen to Spotify and I have my playlist and there'll be cuts on that shit and ding. Ding 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 ding, and I'm like, I'm like wilding out. And when we first heard, I was like, "The fuck is this shit?"
I think that plays a part in a lot of things too. we're so, everything right now is just now. We don't get no time to really digest things and really like take them in. Everything is so instant, you know, Instagram, instant photos, videos popping up instantly. Everything is so boom, 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 new. It's just like, damn, you can't even get a second. It takes these artists so long to develop this body of work. We were just talking about that with you. Like, you got your own collection online now of the best of what you put together yourself. That when you heard it as a collective, you wouldn't have even assumed it was separate pieces all put together. Facts. It sounds like a full body of work.
Right. Yeah, yeah.
So, you know, we got to give art its just due when we're viewing it.
Yeah.
Whether you're listening to it, looking at it, observing it, however you know, we got to give it time. So we so rushed to give an opinion. So what do you think? What do you think right now? Nobody says, well, like, let me fucking get a second to think. Yeah, like,
right.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, that's such a fact. But you know what? I think it also has to do with saturation and just having that online. I was thinking about Joe Button's quote, life is a series of moments and moments is, you know, I don't know the exact quote, but life is a series of moments and moments pass. Mm-hmm. So make your own. So now I'm thinking about what you're saying. Like, shit does, like, when we listen to music, it does kind of go fast.
It's quick.
But back then, how many times you bumped that Slim Shady LP?
Yeah, but look at how frequent music came out back then. That's what I'm saying. Look at how many outlets we had. You had to run into the bootleg nigga on the corner to find the CD. Like, oh, you got it?
That'd be me.
Give me that.
You would cherish that cassette.
You ran the shit out of that CD or that tape.
To the point where it broke. Or scratched up where you can't play it. Facts. Now,
that's true.
It's so easy and music is so saturated because of social media. It's like, you got to listen to this and like another five projects just comes out a couple days later. Mm-hmm. Now. Yeah.
Otherwise, you
that sucks
back.
Too.
Right. Yep.
That Lloyd Banks album, I haven't heard all of it.
Fire.
But yo, it sounds fire. Amazing.
Yeah. Fire.
It's giving me some of that old school feel.
Yeah, but he's so seasoned. It's just his flow. It's just effortless.
The beats is
and
crazy.
Then really listening, like I just got
I haven't
it on,
heard it yet.
I just got it on repeat.
God.
I got it on random.
Yo, I haven't even
and
heard
on repeat.
It all. Like I've heard a couple of joints.
It's crazy.
It like, sounds crazy.
Yeah. And then to hear him with guys like Benny.
I'm like, yo, I'm not ready. I'm just like, I'm not ready. I'm going to get a moment to listen to this.
Oh, nah, we're going to need more than a moment.
And J. Cole shit is too. Like the same thing with J.
That too.
Like I took my time with
Yeah, I haven't heard that new shit. Yeah.
J. Cole shit.
We're
going to
get into that Lloyd Banks on the way home.
He opened up with Cam on the album.
Oh, wow.
Killer. It's just like,
when did that J. Cole come out?
What?
Probably like a month ago.
Oh, Jesus Christ, bro. Let me ask you a question. Because I know when shit come out and I hear it, I post it on my Facebook. Anybody post that shit up on there or something?
No. Sometimes I'll do the iTunes to share to my Facebook
what
and be like, yo, currently
yeah,
listening
I need to.
Yeah.
What I like is that he's using the battle rap format in his content. And I don't know if he's done that I don't know if he's done that a lot because I haven't really been the biggest Cole fan. But I definitely heard this last album, and it's off the chain.
Speaking of battle rap, like, bro, I can see it now. And just due to conversations and the position I'm in now, battle rap is growing to that point where it's going to start becoming a little bit more mainstream. Like, it's getting there.
Oh, yeah, definitely.
It's definitely there now, but it's not fully there yet.
Of course.
Now, and look. Next weekend Drake's gonna be on Caffeine.
That's
you know, to be a part of that, like
it's, that's big, man.
You know, it's
well, he's been in the mix for a while now.
Yes.
And what King of the Dot is doing right now with literally their first season they're filming it as a season one of this.
Wow,
like that's why it's history in the making. They already announced it, like the Grand Prix, like last year. I'm assuming it was a trial type thing. That was the first time they did a tournament style. 100,000 on the line. That's crazy.
That's,
you know what I'm saying?
Brilliant, bro.
From beginning to end, you know what I'm saying? They're broadcasting it as a season.
Wow.
And like and
that's fire, man.
You know what I'm saying? It is, man.
Like, that's dope. Like, look, that's new. That's something different. That's something new. It's making
they're
it more
pushing
interesting.
They're pushing the bar.
Right.
You know?
Yo, that's
they're
dope,
certain celebrities.
Man.
Like, it was Ice-T who was out there last year.
Mm-hmm.
Like, there's certain celebrities that are starting to dabble. You got Remy and Papoose being a part of it more now.
Right.
Like, all the, you know what I'm saying? So it's kind
of. I mean, but even go back, Joe Budden was a part of it. You know?
Yeah, no, in he that sense. Whole, but that was a whole.
Yeah.
Yeah, but I'm just saying, like, there's definitely.
Right. Everybody, yes. Yes.
It just makes me wonder where would it be at? Where would it be at 10 years from now?
Facts. Well, hopefully, your foot and Right. Casino's foot to be in those doors, yeah. You know, talking about those next future moves.
We'll see.
Being yes. a part of the we'll be evolution.
We'll
you know,
be in we'll the definitely same room be all talking about today, years from now.
Maybe.
Remember we were sitting there.
We'll be in the Check the Rhyme. We'll be in the Check the Rhyme penthouse overlooking right? Orlando and shit. You know what I'm saying? Right, right. That'd be hey, the man. Ill shit.
Speaking or on the ground in the barricade.
You know what I'm saying? Fuck the literal it. Whatever. Barricade. Some shit. Nah, no, we're going to be on up. The barricade's going to be on the penthouse, man. It's going to be the barricade penthouse.
Why would you have a cave up there?
But to make
I
everything,
want a real cave.
But oh. to make everything okay. go back full circle.
This nigga's like Barney Rubble shit.
To bring everything back full circle is great to have you back with the league, back battling. And, you know, I know we all looking forward
yo, early,
to
early, facts, man. Earlier we had said something, he had mentioned something like, yo, we all bring something to the table. And don't get it twisted, you know I have my opinions with Gritty and everything. But I am looking forward to Gritty Jersey yourself coming back because, yeah, I fucks with all of y'all.
The game needs it, yeah.
And it's like, oh, man, we've been missing that. And I'm really looking forward to seeing what you guys were doing.
What was the last thing that made you confirm that you was definitely going back at it?
Thing.
Did you was there a point where you weighed everything out, or was it just a you know what point. I'm going back?
The last straw, well, finally, we getting back.
No, it wasn't even no. There was no last straw. It was just an accumulation of energy from different
got you
areas coming at me, like hearing my name in was it Loso
mm-hmm. had a ball. Oh yeah, with Major. Me. Yep.
What's the other dude? Deuce
and Sonny
about me. You know what I'm saying? Yep. And I was just like, damn, I'm still getting mentioned in these battles. I'm like, just like little voice tingling. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying?
Did you have plans to come back? Or?
I wanted to come back. I didn't have a date or an idea who was gonna be on it. I just started fishing around and
we had that in the interview the last time you was here.
I didn't even know what main event. I didn't know who I was gonna battle. All I know is that I wanted a battle. Mm. You know what I'm saying? And if I throw an event, especially for a comeback, I have to be on it. You know what I'm saying? Because
let me ask you a question.
Sheesh.
I mean, what was the conversation like with Gritty and Marino? Like, who were the possible prospects as far as other than Marino that Gritty could have been paired with?
Tried to ask
with
this
Gritty?
Last week.
Shush.
I know. I watched.
See,
the show.
I can say.
I know,
this time.
But this nigga over here.
I turned.
But he watched the show.
That's watched the show. Also, who was eating shrimp?
You know what I'm saying? That's we gotta ask Elvie. I ain't gonna lie.
Nah. First of all, Gritty is a heavyweight.
Facts.
on our platform, as he is, you know, and any platform he gets on, his name just, you know what I'm saying, it's a big name. We always wanted to bring him back. You mm-hmm. know what I'm saying? Our fans always love the Gritty. He always put on a great show.
Yeah.
And I know he's been out of the scene for a while.
Doing his music, yeah.
Me, that's just me, you know, yo, chewing his ear out. Yo, I need you to get on here, man. What's it gonna take? How about this guy? How about that guy? Oh, that on the morning.
Who is this guy or that guy?
You know, because one thing about me is that I'm not selfish.
He's PR'd.
I'm not selfish.
He's very well PR'd.
There's artists, no names, but there are people out there in the world throughout the whole states. There are artists out there who have leagues and make themselves the main event.
Facts.
With the top.
Okay. Top. Yes.
Yeah. We know how that goes.
I've never been.
Yeah.
Like
you're
that.
Very humble.
I'm humble. I'll play. I'll
yours very first. Well could have been.
You know what I'm saying?
Absolutely.
I'll go first. And
I mean, it's not about him. It's about the league.
Yes.
And we see that. Point. We can.
And the league was formatted the way I formatted was for artists because I'm an artist. Mm. So that's why we have three performances. That's why we have an open mic. That's why I make sure that DJ is playing the right music. You know what I'm saying? And I mean, not for nothing, but the event itself is in memory of my nephew. You know what I'm saying? Lunacy. He passed away a couple years ago.
Sorry, Lunacy. That's right. I was like, damn, I hope I'm not killing that name.
Yeah,
Jesus.
Lunacy. He had a movement, and it went by Fam Castle Entertainment, and he used to throw shows like crazy. Had the whole building packed out in our area, in Brevard County.
Wow.
You know what I'm saying? Palm Bay area. He was like the local celebrity there. You know what I'm saying? We lost him. The whole movement lost him. We all heard about it.
Yeah.
He was at every BBA event.
Mm. Wow.
He was
wow.
proud so. That we put on Brevard, the county itself. Mm. That's his county. You know what I'm saying?
So is that where he originally was from?
Yes,
or?
Absolutely.
Oh, wow.
He represents Brevard.
Wow.
I'm from the Bronx.
Right. Yes, from, yeah.
I moved to be closer to family, you know what I'm saying?
And, gotcha.
And at the end of the day, I was able to put Brevard
Got you.
You know what I'm saying? And he loved it.
Yo, you gotta send me his music, man, so we can. I will.
Actually, that's the thing, though. He had an album he was working on, and he never got a chance to release it.
Ah, man.
Was it done? And how far done was it?
It's done. It was completely done.
Okay.
It was just never bounced.
Yeah,
it just was never put out.
Okay. Yeah. You know bounce it and send it, man. And let's blast it off.
That was it, pretty much.
Yeah, let's blast it off, brother.
I mean, I got it. I can send it to
you. Yo, send it real quick. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. It's an MP3, right? We're good?
Yeah. Okay. I'll work on that in the middle of things. But no, the whole thing is really throwing an event in memory of him, because he was always at our events. He always supported us all the time. You know what I'm saying? And it was a big loss for us. You know what I'm saying? And we miss him a lot. So I said,
R.I.P., man.
Yeah, we're gonna do this one for him. You know what I'm saying?
Word up, man.
All right, so let's get into a joint, man, because I want to still rock for the X. You know what I'm saying? This one is Hood Blues, man. Oof, my God. This is one of my favorite cuts on the album. This is with Griselda. So send me that joint so we can, you know what I'm saying, just throw it on immediately after this one. So we got you. CTR23. Check the ROM radio. You already know what it is. Salute.
Talk no steps. Headshot took off so less. More jelly kicks, more jelly sweats. I'm on the yard doing burpees, me drive the fetch. We shoot a land low, he got a new body. Pray to Tesla X, you need a new body. 50K, got my bitch a new body. You internet niggas, y'all pool 90. The ace space sipper, yay dealer. Pray 5 times a day, get on the wave, nigga. Baddest bitch you ever seen doing my braids, nigga. Tech echo like it got delays, nigga. This shit ain't shit, get out the way, nigga. New Yeezys, only me and Ye with them. Pay attention. 400, baby, come back at least 7. Canteen to the rec yard, I got the weapon.
The butcher coming, nigga. You know how I rock 6 figures on Zaza. Come and spend at my shop, I turn your hood to a hot spot. Every game, I feel like I'm Dame, without a stopwatch. Shooting before the shot clock, Griselda got the top spot. Locked down like a pawn shop, nigga, I'm thinking why not. I gave my life to the game, but what do I got? Father these niggas how, I don't even know my pops. This flip phone that I got don't connect to the Wi-Fi. This new foreign shit with the wood on the door. Got me beefing with some niggas I could've put on. They make up lies and put them in songs. I pull up the lies, copping down the block, hit me pulling the yard. Yeah, praying with my dirty hands. I did dirt and scam. I'm asking God, do I deserve these bands? And we from Murderland, Eastside shit, jeans purple brand. Ryan in the GLE, the turtle band.
You throwing shots, you better be precise. If I only squeeze it twice, that's me being polite. We was in the trenches, nigga. 4 chicken wings and rice. The shooter 14 can't read or write, but he gon' squeeze his bite. We was trying to sell a key a night, cause Nas said a G a night wasn't good enough, and he was right. They mad I'm rich, same niggas that wouldn't see my plight. The next plan, I'm riding to the game with KD tonight. Yeah. Machine bitch, A beat our body. My nigga on his way home, he just beat a body. Every time I leave the house, I got the steam about it. My jacket, a one of none, you never seen it probably. I took some cheddar out the vault to pay the lawyer for my man. Weapon possession and felony assault. Whipping up at Unk House, he keep the resi off the fork. I'm Kyrie, hitting niggas with the hezzy on the court. Look, I reached the point niggas never would've thought. Cause every time I drop something, I don't never get support. FN Max shot severing your corpse. You never could extort me. My heart cold is February 4th. They hate to see me win, I'm not surprised, nigga. I'm fucking the bitches, them bum bitches you fuck idolize. I'm in Harlem at Lighthouse eating lobster fries. V and Shooter with me, I got mobster ties. Machine,
bitch. I grew up with the dark side, apartheid. Recording against the panic, kidnapped and hogtied. X. Illish nigga, finish nigga. Never been scared, I'm a fearless nigga. Got the cannon that'll remove your head and shoulders. Got that plan to stand, get ran over. I'ma make you hand over anything you got. Give it up to average motherfuckers. Damn it, cause I'm a savage. Sometimes I can't manage all the shit in my head. I was promised a round, but I got the dirt to stand. Telling like I was bred. Yeah, how you fucking live, nigga.
You know what the fuck it is? You know what the fuck it is, nigga.
I ain't 50 years old for nothing. Right? We ain't 50 years old for nothing. We acting. What the fuck? What the fuck? What the fuck? Wish a nigga would.
I'm with my day ones like say something. Pockets filled up with straight hundreds. Money talk bullshit, walk say something. If you're a nine, yeah, my gun is a cadence, a chopper. I spend my money where it flip, bring it straight to the gossip. Some people switch like Mufasa, they don't got no care for honor. My math is good, I'm Latin hood, but I fix me a problem. I got a vision while y'all stare at the ceiling fan. Living young, but I've been a man, killing mine in my business plan. When my time now, check, that what I'm about. Bet that I hold my city down, don't leave none out. That one's triple O, yeah. Swear to God, I got a mother, brother, sister, father. My cousin, Alton, then my riders. And what I pray for most is knowledge, yeah. My hustle makes sure me okay. For real, I say, you know we okay. Grind off y'all, everybody try to pay me the DOA. I do this here for y'all, this here, I do this for my son. Everyone we love, this here, I do this for my hustle. Make sure me okay. For real, I say, you know we okay. Greatness, thankful for every day to see history in the making. Roll one, finna burn one, finna burn that beat down. Man, I'm finna turn up with a stir cup till I drain that beat down. I got shit to rip, these bitches on it, real in my set, drill in my set. Don't let us go set it off, get real in this bit. My tires skirt, yeah, I'm turning out a virgin. Cause I'm just that nigga, like them don't deserve it. That me, grind so hard, goddamn no sleep. Camera on me, my feet on fleek. Still up in my sagging jeans, don't go open up on no can of bang. For fam, I hold the hammer up, I go to blame and bust. I got my city forever, myself, my world, and that's who I do that for. My hustle making sure me okay. Forever say, you know we okay. Grind off y'all, everybody try to pay me the DOA. I do this here for y'all, this here, I do this for my son. Everyone we love, this here, I do this for my hustle making sure me okay. Forever say, you know we okay.
Thank you. but I ain't saying nothing. I celebrate with every day I wake, breathing when every day it ain't easy from all this pain from lost people.
Yo, 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 what up? This your boy Mellow Man Ace at Padrino. And Trip, when I'm not out performing your favorite hits, I'm tuned into the Check the Rhyme show with my favorite Puerto Rican, GQ the Embassy. Ya tu sabi. Yeah!
Cheat, 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 salute, salute, salute. You already know it is. Favorite Puerto Rican, GQ the Embassy. We are back, man. Man, I wish we had a lot more time.
Whew. That was a good show,
but
man.
That was fire, man.
Touched on a little bit of
Lunisti,
everything.
Lunisti, right? Lunisti, I want to make sure I'm... Lunisti. I'm sorry. I don't know why I say Lunisti.
That's the Spanish.
That's retarded dyslexia in me. I'm so sorry. I'm still battling. I got retarded dyslexia 19. It's official.
Yeah. Sorry to hear that.
I don't think it's contagious.
We couldn't keep a straight face listening to that.
You tried, though.
I tried.
You do good. You do well.
He laughed and fucked it up.
It was coming, and you was like, ah, I won.
I took a breath, but then I heard it, and I was like, oh, that's it.
Yeah, you get a little bit more conditioned with the shit, you know what I'm saying? Casino, you know what I'm saying? He has to deal with it when he's here, and he's like, this nigga here. It's all good. But don't worry, we're gonna be in full serious shenanigans. You know what I'm saying? I even got my Michael Buffer shit, you know what I'm saying, strategized.
My dog is June hosting 12th. The June 12th event.
It's gonna be
BBA.
I co-hosted with Josh. That's how, you know what I'm saying, we started the bill. Now I'm co-hosting with you. Yeah. I forgot which Bear Arms was that one.
That was the Thanksgiving.
That's right, the Thanksgiving. That's very good. You know, my mm-hmm. shit is shot.
Up, man? Well, I'm excited. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, it's going to be. There, you know what I mean? Oh, it's going to be crazy.
Good vibe, man.
It's going to be crazy.
As a league owner, it's a lot of stress, but we're making it happen, making sure everything runs smooth.
Yes.
As an artist, I'm not fucking around.
No, he's not. This nigga's not even trying to do no gritty bullshit. He's like, I am not forgetting no rounds. I'm not going to claim it. Nah. Every round is sharpened.
Nah, I mean, just to throw it out there, you know what I'm saying? You know?
Yeah.
What Don Marino said was real. He's not into the whole...
shit talking. Yeah.
Mean, if I don't like you, maybe.
Right.
But
that goes a long way, man.
That is true.
If I despise you.
Yeah.
Scott, you listening?
I've had some locked-in battles before with people that I don't respect.
Right.
And for some miraculous reason they don't go down, or they don't pull a no show,
gotcha.
Try to cancel. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
And I put all that energy into something.
Alien abductions go up 22% that day.
Yeah,
I make sure that if I'm gonna battle somebody, he's professional.
Okay,
someone who I respect. Someone's pen.
I'm a big fan of both of you. To be honest with you, man.
Well, I respect drive.
Somebody who respects the culture as well. You know,
facts, man. You know. Someone's not going to waste my time. You know what
facts.
I'm saying?
Oh, no. Drops, I know he's not coming to fuck around. You know
Shout out to Drops.
Shout out to Drops, man.
I enjoy watching Drops work. It's going to be a dope battle.
The second coming of Christ to battle rap.
I'm going to try to see if I could be there. It's my daughter's birthday weekend, so I'm going
to... I mean, it's a good birthday present to just bring her to the Brevard Battle Arena.
She's turning 14.
Oh, she's perfect age.
As long as she got an idea that says she's 18.
Oh, my God. I don't want to introduce her to that world.
18 up, man.
Yeah, AKA the back door, only for Josh Dollars.
You know facts. What I'm saying? We almost had a venue like that.
Oh, yeah.
I remember bringing her to an event years ago because out of spite, my lady was like, you ain't going nowhere unless you take your daughter. I'm like, get dressed, baby. We out.
I just need to jump in when daddy says, this bar. Pretend you got a gun, spraying it this way. You know what I'm saying? All that good stuff. Nah, but I mean, I'm definitely looking forward to it. Not just because, you know, I'm part of the event. I mean, like I told you before, man.
Yeah.
I started
you got a nice front row seat.
You know what I'm saying? I started, driving cross country. I was like, you know, let me just sit back and enjoy. I got about a 16-hour drive, and I just started watching. It just kept coming at one after the other. Pause. Brevard Battle Arena, and I was just like, yo, what the fuck? I wasn't aware.
We put a lot of work into a lot of artists that are popping today. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. Colossus.
Shout out to Colossus.
Word Just up. Kyle.
Just Kyle.
Word.
Yeah, him on the show. We got to get Colossus on the show.
We do,
had Complex and, you know, Eye for an Eye and KO and Jers, you know what I'm saying? Zayd. The list goes on. If
These
you,
are some
you know
real
saying?
Motherfuckers.
Yeah,
yeah,
man.
If you know
bar heavy motherfuckers.
Had Lou on there. The Hazardous Smurf.
This first YBS event? first card
with
fan?
BBA?
Yeah.
First YBS. Dope.
That's fire.
That is fire.
I don't even think YBS was battling when I battled 2 Major.
Wow. That's crazy. But I remember him being there. You know what's funny? I was slightly thinking that like for a half a sec, but I was like, because the way they're promoting.
A lot of dudes that are like really popping today weren't on, on the way.
He is on. He is on a climb.
He's definitely going up.
Yeah, yeah.
How much time we got? We got a little time.
We kind of out of time, but you know why? What's up?
All right, no, real quick. This whole the way the battles were set up.
Okay. Yeah.
Was like, if we never stopped,
mm-hmm.
we probably would have been at the level.
Oh, yes, I agree. So definitely.
Reason,
I agree.
The reason why, you know, you get Gritty or get a Don Marino is because we all feel like we would have been on that Don Marino wave if we never would have stopped.
Or even beyond.
You know or even
so,
beyond. Yeah.
So this is us reclaiming our positions, reclaiming our spots. We're not just going to jump in and get a warm up battle because this is what we do. We've been did this. You know what I'm saying?
Yes.
If we're going to come back for it. We're going to come back to reclaim our position.
Yeah, you know talk about practice?
Yeah, exactly.
Right?
So, practice?
You know, and that's the big deal, you know what I'm saying?
Gritty Iverson.
Gritty calling, you know, himself an underdog. We all feel kind of that way because we have to reclaim that position.
Right, so gotcha.
My thing was
just
like,
because of his pause.
My thing right was like, who's hot in the state of Florida? Who's really hot right now that I got to knock out to get my shine back? You know what I'm saying? So that's the challenge between people like me, myself, Jerz, you know, Gritty, who we you know, our reputation is there.
Right.
But we haven't been get as active as some of these guys out there. So we want to get back in the ring with the guys who are actually active so we can say, you know what I mean? That's my spot.
Right.
That's why that's my
who's
spot.
Standing right here?
I feel like we're getting the shit we need to hear.
Yeah, who's standing right here?
Yo.
Somebody was holding this spot for me. You standing there.
Oof, let's get this. Let's get this quick rundown of the of June 12th. Again, this is Brevard Battle Arena. Co-hosted by yours truly, GQ the Embassy, your favorite Puerto Rican. West Side Sports Bar and Lounge. That's 3026 West New Haven Avenue in Melbourne, Florida, 32904. All you gotta do is Google West Side Sports Bar and Lounge. Mm-hmm. It will pop up. Food. Open mic. Starts at 8. You said same. What?
Food and full liquor.
That's
full, liquor.
Full and full bar.
But no foolery is going to be allowed. And it's $20 at the door. I've just got the confirmation. $19.75 will get you in the building. I'm just going to throw it out there.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, we take quarters.
You know what I'm saying?
Pennies, nickels, dimes, quarters.
Yeah, they said, GQ, you're wilding out. Anything that adds up to 20, we're taking that shit.
We will thank it.
But do not come in here with 1992 paper food stamps. It's not fucking happening.
No.
Can't do nothing with that shit.
If it's going to be food stamps, it got to be $40.
You know what I'm saying? Facts. We're doing, you know what I'm saying? We do cash out WIC checks, but you're getting bodega prices.
Right.
Facts.
We do Cash App as well.
Yeah, with Zelle. Cash App, Zelle. You know what I'm saying?
You want to do it. Right?
Gotta get with the wave. Yeah. Actually, I don't know, man. It depends on how your account is set up, where they take out.
Right.
So it might be a little extra, so that way you get that 20.
Give or take, you know?
Give it,
I'm excited, man.
That's what's up.
Brought to you by the man himself, who is also battling in the event.
Casino 183rd.
I don't know how I do it, man.
We gonna see.
You know what I'm saying?
I'm looking forward to it.
We know how it's going to go.
We know how it's happening.
Shit's going to be bloody knuckles and all that shit. Nigga. Right. We already know.
You can look at all my other battles and see how those went.
Yeah, for sure. You look at Casino 183rd's battles, you look at Drive's battles, and I'm telling you, this is the reason why kids are not allowed. You know what I'm saying? Because this shit is going to go down. It's like the Wild Wild West. The fucking tumbleweed's going to be rolling. Right. And these motherfuckers
It's going to be a good time, man.
It's going to be a great, great fucking event.
If you like this type of shit, this is your type of shit.
Yeah, facts. Open mic starts at 8 p.m. Do not be late. Music by DJ Drift.
The earlier the better. You definitely don't want to miss
this. This is also in loving memory of album release party 4.
Lunacy.
Yeah, because I will destroy a beautiful name. You know what I'm saying? Lunacy. And let me tell you something. Just playing those cuts, man, the album's got to be ridiculous, bro.
It's fire.
That balcony joint is definitely my shit.
That's
yo.
My shit. Wow.
That shit is hard.
That's a hip hop cut.
You know what I'm saying? Get that screw face going.
Go ahead and plug up all your social media information. Tell the people where they can reach you, follow you, view you.
You most reach me on Instagram. At Casino183rd, you know what I'm saying? You want to email me, casino183rd@gmail.com. Facebook, you know, you could find me there as well, Casino. You know what I'm saying? Just look up Casino 83rd. I should pop up easily.
Mm-hmm. We have SoundCloud as well.
Yo, word. SoundCloud, Casino 183rd, and also BX Reps. YouTube, Casino 183rd. If you Google Casino 183rd, you're going to find me.
Facts. Ladies, don't get crazy. Pebs is wild like that.
Yeah, my wife will.
She will shoot the place up. Yeah, you know what I'm saying?
All respect, please.
Yeah. She'll shoot you, then stab your corpse just for the hell of it.
Yeah, right? Stick a fork in it. Right?
Josh, man, you already know, man. Plug yourself.
Y'all already know, man. Joshua Dollars Facebook, Mr. Josh Dollars Instagram, Joshua Dollars on PlayStation if you want that Mortal Kombat smoke or that Call of Duty smoke.
What's the, and, what's the Mortal Kombat you play?
11.
11? Okay, okay. Yeah, now that I know. I might get it so you can whoop my ass on that shit. I'm not really good at those games. But anyway,
I've been online.
I digress. Continue.
It's rough out
it's
there.
It's real.
It's a bunch of scorpions out there.
Really?
Yeah, man. That's all they
I'm
play with.
I'm a Kung Lao. I'm a Kung Lao.
I'm a Johnny Cage guy, you know?
I was always a Raiden kind of guy.
He's fire in the game.
Yeah. Yeah.
But yeah, man. Follow me. Tap in. Please share, like, subscribe. Hit the YouTube. Check the rhyme. You already know what it is, man. Bless up. Thank you for always watching, viewing, supporting. And I'll let my man GQ do the rest, man.
Yeah, you already know what it is, man. It's favorite Puerto Rican GQ to Embassy. Make sure you hit me up on Snapchat, TikTok, Twitter, SoundCloud, Reverb Nation, Instagram at GQ to Embassy, and also at Check the Rhyme Radio. Facebook, like me at GQ to Embassy, and also at Check the Rhyme Radio. PayPal.me/GQ to Embassy, dollar for a holla. Cash App, $GQ to Embassy. Make sure you subscribe to the channel. Go to YouTube.com/Check the Rhyme Radio. Subscribe,
hit
like,
that bell button,
hit
man.
That bell.
We got all, something for you
sure,
every week.
Yeah, make sure you hit all on the notification so you're always getting notified for that shit. And leave comments. You know, comments are a beautiful thing. And smash that like button so that way we stay relevant in that shit. You know what I'm saying?
Word
we,
up.
We trying to get a lot of new content out there, and we trying to make sure that it gets out there. You know what I'm saying? So, with that being said,
tell a friend to tell a friend, man.
Word up. Tell a baby mama to tell a baby daddy. I don't care what it is. You know what I'm saying? Just let niggas know when you're smashing. Scream out, Check the Rhyme. It's for all I care. It is. My bad. I'm wilding out. Shout to Fuego. Unnecessary news. Necessary news. I'm
shout
sorry.
Shout out to Lou Berra.
Ashley, her first time ever being on radio. She did an amazing job. You know what I'm saying? I can't front.
Look so forward to more content.
Hit her up on Instagram at the original Fuego. Don't get crazy because
we crazy.
I do shoot and stab as well. You know what I'm saying? Me and Pebs, we're on the same time. You know
allegedly.
So love y'all to death. You know what I'm saying? Make sure you tune in every week. Check the Rhyme Radio on Facebook so that way you can always watch us live. If not, check the Rhyme Radio on YouTube at some point during the week. You know what I'm saying? I do post up the video. So we love y'all to death. And yeah, it is what it is.
Peace, y'all love, man.
Cheer, salute. We out.
Cheer, salute, Orlando and worldwide. Appreciate the love. New listeners, love. Loyal listeners, love. Make sure you tune in next week, 6 to 7. Where? Only right here, IndieJamsRadio.com.
Cheer, 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 salute, salute, salute. Y'all know it is. Favorite sort of being GQ to Embassy. Make sure you share this video. We appreciate everybody that was tuned in. We appreciate everybody that supports this channel, that shares, you know, all that good shit. Make sure you hit me up on TikTok, Snapchat, Twitter, SoundCloud, Reverb Nation, Instagram, at GQ to Embassy, and also at Check the Rhyme Radio, Facebook. Like us at Check the Rhyme Radio, and also at GQ the Embassy. Make sure you subscribe to the channel on Facebook. That is at Check the... I mean, sorry. Subscribe to the channel on YouTube at Check the Rhyme Radio. Fuck it. Make sure, again, Facebook as well, Check the Rhyme Radio. It is what it is. We love y'all to death. June 12th, BBA, be in attendance. You know what I'm saying? Make sure you look up Westside Sports Bar and Lounge in Melbourne, Florida. Be there, 8 o'clock. $20 gets you in. I don't give a fuck if you got $10 and 100 quarters. It is what it is. Just make sure you got 20, and it's all love. Shout out to Pebs in the building. Shout out to Casino 183rd. Yo, we love y'all to death. Y'all already know what it is, nigga. We out. Yeah.
Look at this. Yo, voy yo, man. Federico. Hacer una cosa, la cosa que le voy a decir es eso, ¿ok? Bien clara. Try to have each other partying without a teller. She made me kite.